Welcome to DEO Nalgonda online classes. My name is Ram Reddy. Today we are going to discuss about physical science subject in 9th class. Topic is heat. In that subtopic is determination of specific heat of a solid. Repeating once, determination of specific heat of a solid. Before that, derivation, we need to discuss one more concept, principle of method of mixture. Principle of method of mixtures. Principle of method of mixture. If you can take more than two substances, more than two substances means iron nail, wood, again it is made with brass, it is made with bronze, and it is made with another material, it is also made with another material. Whenever you are observing all these are at various temperatures, nothing but these are at different temperatures. If you can take hot bodies also, no problem. Whatever may be the bodies which are maintaining at different temperatures, when more than two substances are brought into thermal contact with one another, at that moment here, heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold body. Net heat lost by hot body is equal to net heat gained by the cold body. When it is possible, all the substances are at various temperatures, all the substances are compulsory thermal contact with one another, at that moment only hot bodies can be losing their temperature, cold bodies can be gaining their temperature. What is our principle of method of mixture? Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. Nothing but net heat lost from hot body, net heat lost by hot body is equal to net heat gained by cold body. This only can be recalled as here principle of method of mixture. Right, once again repeating here, net heat lost by hot body or bodies is equal to net heat gained by the cold body. Right, this can be recalled as here principle of method of mixtures. At the same time, now we are going to do our lab activity, that is determination of specific heat of a solid. The specific heat of a solid, the solid is a marble, right? For that, what materials are required? What is our aim? What is the procedure? We are going to show with lab activity. Now, what is our aim? Aim is determination of specific heat of a solid. The solid is a lead shot, nothing but aim is right to find the specific heat of a lead shot. Right, to find specific heat of a solid. Solid means here lead shot. Lead shot means here marble, which we are playing here. For that, material required are here. You see, whatever may be the solid, you need to find the specific heat, that is lead shot and calorimeter, copper calorimeter. The calorimeter is right made with copper, and wooden box. It is the stirrer to stir the objects which are placed inside the copper container. At the same time, thermometer can be used to measure the initial temperature and final temperature of this system. At the same time, steam heater, nothing but the water which contains at 100 degree centigrade. The water which is present in this is at 100 degree centigrade. At the same time, water also. Right, these are the materials required for this activity. Now, you can take copper calorimeter. Right, procedure we are discussing here. Copper calorimeter, which is placed inside the box. What is the need of placing inside the box? Because of no heat loss to the surroundings, we can get accurate values of specific heat of a solid. The solid is here, lead shot. First, you can calculate the mass of calorimeter along with the stirrer. That is M1 mass. M1 is the mass of calorimeter. Mass of calorimeter with stirrer is equal to M1. Afterwards, you need to pour some water, nothing but 1/3 of this copper calorimeter is filled with water. Again, you can measure the mass of all these contents. At this moment here, we can get here mass of calorimeter plus stirrer plus water, that is equal to M2. Now, children, you can measure the mass of only water. Only mass of water, that is equal to M2 minus M1. You can take care. All these could be at one temperature only. You can measure by the help of thermometer, which is placed inside the copper calorimeter, like this here. Which one is with the same temperature? Copper calorimeter with stirrer and water all together can be at T1 temperature. Temperature of copper calorimeter plus stirrer and water all together can be at T1 temperature. All contents, nothing but all contents, contents initial temperature, that is T1 degree Celsius. Right, copper calorimeter with stirrer and water all together can be maintaining only one temperature, that is T1 degree centigrade. Afterwards, you can take one heat chamber. You can take one heat chamber at separate. It is our heat chamber, right, which maintains 100 degree Celsius. Heat chamber which maintains 100 degree Celsius. The heat chamber temperature can be taken as T2. Right, heat chamber temperature, that is T2, you can maintain every time 100 degree centigrade only. In that, you can place our lead shot. It is also at 100 degree centigrade only. Nothing but the steam heater could be maintained same temperature. Later, by the help of forceps, you can transfer the lead shots with minimum heat loss to the surroundings. You can place inside the calorimeter like this here. Inside the calorimeter, you can stir it here. 1 minute only, less than 1 minute only you can stir it here. Not to stir also, no problem. At this moment here, you can see here the lead shot is heart body and the contents which are present here all together can be recalled as here cold bodies. Before that you see here mass of right copper calorimeter plus stirrer plus water. Again you placed here lead shots. Lead shot nothing but marble lead shot, that is M3. Lead shot mass is M3. Once again I am repeating here, whatever may be the lead shot, again those contents all together mass can be taken as M3. At the same time steam heater could be maintaining 100 degrees centigrade, that is T2. Now you see here only the mass of lead shot. Now only the mass of lead shot, nothing but PB shot, that is M3 minus M2. Whenever you placed our marble inside the copper calorimeter, here lead shot is hot body, remaining contents are cold bodies. Already before only we discussed here principle of method of mixture. By the help of principle of method of mixture, heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. Net heat lost hot body is equal to net heat gained by cold body. We need to apply this concept to our marble lead shot. Lead shot is hot body. Here cold bodies are here calorimeter, stirrer along with water. Calorimeter plus stirrer with water all together can be gaining temperature from the lead shot. These all together are thermal contact with one another. Whenever the materials are thermal contact with one another, they are brought into same temperature, that only can be recalled as here thermal equilibrium temperature. The thermal equilibrium temperature of this system, total system means here copper calorimeter, stirrer, water, lead shot, all together can be recalled as here equilibrium temperature. That equilibrium temperature is T3 is the equilibrium temperature, right? Equilibrium temperature or equilibrium temperature that is T3 degree Celsius. Equilibrium temperature of the system is T3 degree Celsius. At that equilibrium temperature, what contents are present here? Copper calorimeter, stirrer and water and lead shots all together are present. Now you can apply the principle of method of mixture. Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. Nothing but net heat lost by lead shot is equal to net heat gained by what materials? Calorimeter plus stirrer plus water. Heat gained by these are calorimeter, stirrer plus water. All these can be gaining. It is losing. Already we know one concept here. Q is equal to MS delta T. That formula already we know here. At this point, that formula can be applied to this system. At the same time, this system. At this moment here, T2 is the final temperature and T3 is the equilibrium temperature. In this case here, T3 is the final temperature, T1 is the initial temperature. Because of it is a hot body, it is an cold bodies. So we can able to write here ms delta t formula. We can able to find the quantity of heat lost by lead shot is equal to quantity of heat gained by the copper calorimeter, stirrer plus water. So m3 minus m2 into right here lead shot specific heat can be call as here SL. If you can take the lead shot of specific heat is SL MS delta T. Delta T, in this case of delta T we can able to write final temperature is T2, right? Nothing but higher temperature is T2 and equilibrium temperature is 33. Nothing but higher temperature minus lower temperature, variation in temperature, that is equal to MS delta T, that is equal to heat gained by copper calorimeter, mass of calorimeter M1, and specific heat of calorimeter is, calorimeter means nothing but SC. SC is the copper calorimeter specific heat. At the same time delta T, here also delta T, that is here T3 minus T1. Why T3 minus T1? T3 is final temperature, T1 is initial temperature, right? Again you can apply to water. Water at this point here mass of water is M2 minus M1, right? Specific heat of water is SW. Again thermal equilibrium temperature at this moment here T3 and initial temperature of the system is T1. So at this moment you can get here, right, T3 minus T1 here, T3 minus T1 here. What is the reason behind that to maintain same? Because of these two contents are at one temperature only. In this here and in this, the two are common. M3 minus M2 of SL, that is T2 minus T3 is equal to, right, you can able to write here M1 SC, right, plus M2 minus M1 of SW into overall T3 minus T1. Now you are going to find the specific heat of lead shot. SL is equal to, all these things can comes down. At this moment here M1 SC, specific heat of calorimeter, it is made with copper. At the same time M2 minus M1, mass of water and specific heat of water, that is 1. Copper specific heat is 0.095. At the same time those temperatures we can able to measure by the help of thermometer, T3 minus T1 by M3 minus M2, that is the mass of lead shots, M3 minus M2 again, right, steam heater temperature is T3, already it is maintaining 100 degrees centigrade, right, equilibrium temperature is T2 minus T3, T2 minus T3, here steam heater temperature and equilibrium temperature, T2 minus T3. So by the help of this formula we can able to find specific heat of a lead shot, right? That only our concept here, determination of specific heat of a solid. The formula is here M1 SC. SC means here calorimeter specific heat, it is made with copper. M2 minus M1, it is a mass of calorimeter. M2 minus M1 is the mass of water, specific heat of water, T3 minus T1 by M3 minus M2 of T2 minus T3, right? It is our derivation. Now we are going to discuss about evaporation. Right, in day-to-day life we are observing about evaporation, right, by observing and petri dishes, right, it is the dropper. If you can take dropper, right, By the help of dropper, you can take some spirit. Some spirit, if you can place on your palm. After few minutes, the spirit is disappears. Your feeling is very cool. What is the reason behind that? We are going to discuss in detail way about this feeling by the help of evaporation concept. Evaporation is the cooling process. How the evaporation could be done in day-to-day life, we will discuss in detail way. Whenever you are observing towards our mother, mother is washing clothes. After washing clothes, mother can be keeping those clothes like this here. It is in opening mode. Then only all together can be dried up. Otherwise, if your mother can be placed like this, the wet clothes becomes into wet only. They are not able to dry up. At the same time, whenever you are observing towards windy day and sunny day, at the same time, clouds are present in the atmosphere. Many different seasons are there. At that moment, you can observe the day-to-day life activities. Once you see at your home, before festival, we are washing our floors. After 2-3 minutes, if you can on the fan, the water can be disappear. Wet floor becomes into dry. Where does go that water? What is the reason behind that? Already in 7th class, 6th class, we have seen here, water boils at 100 degree centigrade. Is it 100 degree centigrade can be provided by anyone for these all materials? After raining, you see here, some droplets can be present on the surfaces, roads and all. 2-3 minutes, where does go the water? We can say that water is evaporated. Evaporation. Evaporation is the surfaced phenomena. How the evaporation can be done? At the same time, what factors are affecting on evaporation? We will discuss in detail way by the help of some activities. See children, in day-to-day life, you can take China dish. It is our China dish. It is our tissue tube. Right, these are we can use in this lab activity. At the same time, whenever you are observing towards tea shop, tea cup will be again bottom, saucer will be. Some are placing the tea inside the saucer. Some are direct they are taking. What is the reason behind that? If you can take the tea inside the saucer, right, it can cool soon than this. What is the difference is occurred in between these all, we will discuss in detail way. Where does go that heat energy from the substance? Take two petri dishes like this petri dish. By the help of dropper, you can pour some spirit. Right, 2-3 drops of spirit. Afterwards, you can place under the ceiling fan, which is in on mode. The ceiling fan, which is in on mode, after few minutes, the spirit lamp which is present inside the petri dish or watch glass can be disappeared. Where does go that one here? Again, another petri dish or watch glass can be taken. In that also, same amount of spirit can be taken. But at this moment here, you can place one lid. Reversely, one lid can be placed like this here. Again, you can place under the ceiling fan. When the ceiling fan is rotates, the spirit which is present inside the lidded one, we are not able to see disappear. The spirit which is present in open one, it is disappear. What is the reason behind that? The reason is here, once you see here, the molecules which are present inside the petri dish, open petri dish, we are discussing about open petri dish, how the evaporation phenomena is going on. You see here, inside the petri dish, many water molecules are present. Right, these water molecules, you see how those can be right, escaping from the surface of this petri dish. If air can be blows on the surface, air can be blows on the surface of petri dish or watch glass, right, whatever may be the molecules which are present inside this air, those can be collide with one another. Whenever they are in collide, right, they can get into motion, right, they can get into kinetic energy. Already we know that here kinetic energy is directly proportional to the temperature. Their temperature also can be increases. They can get into energy in terms of kinetic energy. As usual, their temperature also can be increases. The molecules which are present at bottom, they also can be collide with one another. But the collision is more on the surface, lesser inside the petri dish or watch glass. Right, at this moment here, whatever may be the particles collide with one another, they can be transmitting energy to the particles which are on the surface of water level. On the surface of water level means here on the surface of watch glass, right, which are present on the watch glass, right, bottom water molecules can be transferring their energies to the upper portion molecules of water which are present in the watch glass. At this moment here, you see here, those molecules can be enter in the atmosphere. Whenever they are getting to energy, as usual they can enter in the atmosphere. But air is blowing on, along with the air, all those particles also moving. Moving air is called as wind now. So all those particles are moving. This phenomena is continuously going on. The particles can be collide continuously. They are transmitting energy to the upper portion particles. Upper portion particles can be enter in the atmosphere. Some of the particles can be collide with the air or atmospheric humidity. Some can be rejoins along with the particles which are present in the watch glass. But escaping particles are more than returned particles. Escaping particles are more than returned particles. This phenomena is continuing. After several minutes, you are not able to see any water molecule inside the watch glass like this here. It is in empty mode. This only can be recalled as here evaporation. At the time of evaporation, total system temperature can be decreased. You see here, no water molecule is present in this air. So what happened? All the particles can be escaping, their energies can be sending into atmosphere. They are mixing in the atmosphere only. So no water molecules can be present. As usual, temperature of this system can be zero. We are not able to see any water molecules inside the watch glass. At the same time, another one also we have here. Once you see, it is our china dish. If you can take some water inside the china dish, another china dish also can be taken, right? Another china dish also, right? You can pour some water. Afterwards, one china dish can be placed inside the classroom. Another china dish can be placed inside the cupboard. If you can place inside the cupboard. At the same time, if you can take one test tube, in this also you can pour some water by the help of dropper, right? These three can be placed at different places. After 1 hour or 2 hours, you can observe some concepts here. The petri dish or china dish which is placed inside the cupboard, there is no change in the water level. At the same time, along with this china dish, you can place our tissue tube also. No change in the water level which is present inside the tissue tube also, same. But inside the china dish only, the water level can be decreased. Where does go that water? This phenomena only can be occurring. Due to that phenomena, water can be escaping from the china dish. But in this case, we have to see surface area. Surface area also can affect on rate of evaporation. We have to see surface area. Starting only we discussed here, mother can be spread out the saris and shirts. Without spreading that, water could not be disappear from the shirt or anyone. If like this, already we discussed here, water could not be disappeared. If you can spread, that can be evaporated. Nothing but area. Area also can affect on the rate of evaporation. Right, at the same time, once you see in day-to-day life, many situations are occurring. Whenever you are working, if you can work at one place, right, whatever may be the physical work, automatically our body temperature can be increases because of heartbeat also increases. Right, whenever heartbeat increases, the blood which is flows inside the veins can be moving very fast. Whatever may be the body is in the motion, it is getting to kinetic energy. Already we know kinetic energy is directly proportional to the temperature. Temperature of the body can be increases. Right, in general, total temperature of the body can be increases. Sweat glands contains start evaporation. Sweat glands contains some water content. The water content can be starts evaporation. You can able to get sweat on the surface of our skin. After 2 minutes, we feel very cool because of evaporation. Nothing but evaporation is the cooling process. At the same time, it is an surfaced phenomena. Why we call as surfaced phenomena? Because of surfaced molecules only can be enter in the atmosphere first. The molecules which are present at the bottom, they can be transferring energy to the surfaced particles. Those surfaced particles can be enter in the atmosphere vicinity. Vicinity means here surrounding. Surrounding area can be filled by these water molecules. Nothing but evaporated water molecules. But whenever wind blows, those vicinity can be vanished. Vanished means here they are apart from that place. Right, continuously this process can be going on. So the system temperature can be reduced. Whatever may be the system temperature can be reduced. So it is an cooling process. At the same time, all the particles are escaping from the surface of this water level. So it is considered as surfaced phenomena. At the same time, what factors are affecting on evaporation? Rate of evaporation, right, could be depends upon three factors. One is surface area. Number two is temperature. Number three is humidity. Already you know in social, humidity means the amount of water vapor present in the air. The amount of water vapor present in the air is called humidity. Here temperature, already we know, degrees of heatness of a body or degrees of coldness of a body is called temperature. Surface area means already we discussed by the help of China dish, right, at the same time kerchief. Right, spreading kerchief and closing kerchief. Right, once you see here, surface area is increases, automatically rate of evaporation is increased. Best example, if you can spread the clothes, then only it will becomes into dried up. Otherwise, they are not able to dried up. So surface area can be increases, rate of evaporation also increases. So directly proportional with to evaporation. So temperature, whenever temperature has to increase, automatically rate of evaporation also could be increases. It is also directly proportional with one another. Right, but humidity is inverse proportion. It is different one here. Right, humidity is inversely proportional to evaporation. How does like it means once you see here, at rainy season, water content is more in the atmosphere, right? The clouds means nothing but water vapor only, that could be surrounding in the atmosphere, right? At this moment here, humidity is more. The amount of water vapor present in the air is called humidity. Whenever humidity is more, automatically evaporation can be less. Because of humidity means here wet only, wet, right? Wet in condition. How the wet can be losing again? Wet to wet it is not possible. Wet to dry it is possible. So humidity is more, evaporation is less. In general, rainy season, the clouds could not dry up soon, right? Comes to windy day and sunny day. Wind day, nothing but wind blows on the surface of objects, whatever may be the wet objects, they can becomes into dry up soon here. At the same time, sunny day means here hot summer like that here. Comparing in between these two here, at a place of windy day only, evaporation can be takes place more than sunny day. So finally we can able to get here, evaporation is the cooling process, right? The system temperature can be decreasing. At the same time, it is an surface to phenomena. These three factors can be affecting on rate of evaporation. In the following videos, we are going to discuss about reverse process of this evaporation, nothing but condensation, next to boiling, melting, freezing, latent heat of vaporization, latent heat of fusion. All these concepts we are going to discuss. At the same time, anomalous effect of water, nothing but strange behavior of water, we will discuss in the following videos. Thank you.